everyone. I'm here at Kanpur. I'm just waiting for some more of you to join in, and then I'm going to start doing my makeup. In case you don't know me, my name is Ankita and my blog is called. Since we have some of you joining in, I think I'm going to start with my makeup. So I have a masterclass and a meet and greet happening here later today at the Z Square Mall in Kanpur. And I'm just getting ready at the Nykaa Lux store. I've got some of my favorite products here. So let's get started. I've already prepped my skin and I use the Clinique Moisture Surge. This is the 72-hour one. And I mix a little bit of the MAC Strobe Cream in Pink Light. Tinkle says your skin looking so good. Thank you. It's the magic of these two products. So I've got Pink Light here. And this just gives like a very subtle, nice glow to the skin. So we've used these two products and I'm going to get started with my makeup for foundation, because I have an event here. I want my makeup to last all day. I want my skin to look flawless. I'm using the Estee Lauder Double Wear Stay in Place, and the shade I have is Cashew. And this is a really good foundation for special occasions, bridals, parties, because it lasts really long. It gives you really high coverage. I'm just going to take a little bit on the back of my hand. And I'm just going to go in with a sponge. And just bounce this on my skin. Radhe asks, does it work for oily skin? Yes, this is really good for oily skin. Very long lasting. It has a little bit of oil control as well. It's not like a super dewy foundation, so it's not something that makes your skin oily over time. So Sonal asks, please tell primer name. I use the MAC Strobe Cream with a moisturizer to prime my skin. And I've got a few blemishes. You'll just see how this just covers everything. So when I'm using this foundation, I don't always need a concealer because this is really high coverage. What about someone who sweats a lot? For sweating, I think a powder can help, because powder products are just going to absorb some of that sweat. So make sure you set your foundation with a loose powder. So I'm quite happy with the coverage on the face. I feel I just need a little more for my under eyes. So I'm going to use the Instant Full Cover Concealer from Bobbi Brown. And this is the shade Natural. This is again a high coverage concealer. It's great for events. It's great when you want your makeup to last really long. Also really good for brides. I think some of you who joined late asking me which foundation I've used. I've used the Estee Lauder Double Wear Stay in Place. And Estee Lauder Double Wear Hair, they have like loads of other foundations now in the same range, but the one I've used is the original Stay in Place makeup. Hi guys, hi to everyone who's joining in now. Someone's asking, what kind of eye look are you planning today? I'm planning on a neutral eye. I'm going to use some nice soft eyeshadows on my top lid, and then I'm going to just do like a smoky liner, and then just lots of mascara. Just a simple eye. You can see how much this has brightened my under eyes. Just like I'd use just like 3 or 4 dots of it, and this is really long lasting as well, just like the foundation. My base is pretty much done. What I'm going to do now is let's get get started with the eye makeup. So my brows are naturally quite full. I don't typically like do too much with my eyebrows. What I'm going to do is I'm going to keep the brows really simple today. I'm using the MAC Pro Longwear Waterproof Brow Set. Once again, this is really long lasting product. So my brows will stay in place all day. So whenever you're doing your eyebrows, it's a nice idea to set it with some kind of gel and always just brush it upward and outward. Done. I'm really happy with like how full they look, and I'm going to start with the eye makeup. So like some of you were asking what kind of look I'm doing today, I'm going to do something quite simple. I've got this Estee Lauder palette. This is called Fairy Saffron. It's got a really nice mix of neutrals. You've got a couple of matte shades, couple of light satiny shimmery colors, and this really nice highlighter. I actually plan on using this same for highlighting my face. I'm going to start with this color right here. I'm just going to grab a brush. I've got some really nice brushes from Estee Lauder today. This is the blending shadow brush in number 25. What I'm doing is I'm just going to grab these two colors together. I don't want a very matte eye. I want like just like a hint of shimmer, but not something too sparkly. Hi guys, hi to everyone who's joining in now. It just adds a bit of shadow, just a little bit of color now. If you guys have any questions about the products I'm using, please don't be shy, you can ask and I'll answer your questions as I'm doing my makeup. And then I'm going to take just a flatter brush and the same colors. I'm going to use them a little bit along my lower lash line. Got like a light wash of shadow. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to take an eyeliner, and I want a really soft eye. I don't want something too harsh. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply a pencil along my upper lash line. I've got here the MAC Technicolor liner. This is Graph Black, and I'm going to apply it along my top lash line, and before it sets I'm just going to take a brush. I've got the MAC 219. This is a really nice pencil brush. It's great for smudging liner. It's great for any lower lash line work. And when you're doing this, you want to make sure that your liner stays as close to your lash line as possible. You don't want any gaps. I'm going to use this. Are you in Kanpur? Yes, I am in Kanpur. And we're doing an event later today at the Z Square Mall. It's a masterclass in meet and greet. So smudging the liner like this just gives you like a softer look. It still gives you definition of a liner, but it's just a little softer. the liner I'm using, I think some of you have just joined in. The liner is MAC Technocol, and this is the shade Graph Black. It's a nice rich black. You can use this as a kajal as well, and it's very long lasting. Excited to see you guys because this is the first time I'm doing an event in Kanpur. Are you in Set Square Mall? Yes. Okay, what I'm trying to do is just match the two eyes. I think I need a little more on my left eye. Hello, Shivani. Is it daily routine makeup? This is something you can do every day. Although I would suggest a lighter foundation for every day. Or what you can do is you can use the same foundation, just mix it with a moisturizer. So it will sheer it down a bit. But I'm using really muted colors. So this is something you can do. Finish off the look with some mascara, and I've got one that I like a lot, and I've used this so much in the past. This is the Sumptuous Extreme Mascara by Estee Lauder. Before I do that, I'm just going to curl my lashes. Curling your lashes, it's just going to lift your lashes, it's going to make your eyes look a little more open. Especially if you're someone who has droopy lashes, I feel like curling the lashes just makes such a difference to your eyes. Foundation for oily skin in summer, which one is best? This is great for summer, and for oily skin, the Estee Lauder Double Wear Stay in Place. Your lip shade, I'm not wearing anything on my lips yet, I'll do my lip in the end. Okay, so we've got the mascara. It's got a nice dense brush. So it just grabs hold of each lash. It coats it really nicely. And whenever you're doing mascara, always start at the base, right here, and then move it in this wiggling motion upwards. Make sure you do the inner lashes as well as the outer lashes properly. Any alternative for foundation? I also really like the MAC Studio Fix. That's another one that's very long lasting. It's great for the summer, it's great for oily skin. It's also good for someone who's got blemishes. If they want something high coverage, the Studio Fix works really nicely. And they have so many shades. I'm not sure how many, but they've got a ton of shades, and they've introduced several new ones. So I've got my mascara on the top lash. To do the same on the bottom lashes. Best compact for summer. For summer, I think it's a good idea to use a loose powder, because that just gives you better oil control instead of compact. So you can see what a difference mascara makes. And a lot of people don't do their lower lashes. And I know it takes a little time to get used to doing mascara on your bottom lashes if you are someone who's starting with makeup. But I feel like it can make such a difference to the eyes when you do both top and the bottom lashes. Best blush in the summer. I personally prefer using more powder products in the summer as compared to cream or liquids, because I feel they just work better for me. Because when you're sweating a lot, and when it's really hot and your skin is getting oily, if you're using a lot of liquids and creams, they tend to like move around. If it's a powder, it just stays on better. Which mascara are you using? I'm using the Estee Lauder Sumptuous Extreme Lash Multiplying Volume Mascara. And this is what it looks like. It's this gold and navy tube. Foundation for dry skin. So Estee Lauder, in the same double wear range, they also have one called Nude Water Fresh, and that's a really nice foundation for dry skin. It gives about sheer to medium coverage, but it's very hydrating. It gives you a really nice dewy finish, so if you have dry skin, you can do that. And the bottom lashes, and then my eye makeup is done. And when you're doing your bottom lashes, it's helpful if you just like tilt your face down like that, so you don't get a lot of smudges on your skin. And similarly, when you're doing top lashes, you can tilt your face back like that, so you don't get mascara smudges on your crease. So my eyes are done. I'm going to do a little bit of contouring, just nothing too crazy, something very gentle. I've got the Bobbi Brown bronzing powder, and this is the shade, I think it's just called bronzing powder. And I'm going to grab this brush, Estee Lauder blush brush. I'm just going to add a little bit of structure to my face with this. You're joining in now. Hi guys. The eyeliner I have used is the MAC Techna Hole. Let me show you what it looks like. This is the one, and the shade is Graff Black. It's the black shade. I really like this because it's, you can see it's not too harsh. It's not like a muddy streak on your face. It just gives you a bit of definition, a little bit of warmth. Use this on my left cheek as well. Foundation I used. Okay, for all of you who have joined in late, I used the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation, the Stay In Place. And the shade I wear is Cashew. This is what it looks like. A little bit along my jawline as well. And whenever you are using a contour product, it's important to use something in a matte finish, because what you're doing is you're adding shadows to your face. You don't want something which has shimmer, because that's just going to reflect light. So when you use something to highlight, you use something which has, say, shimmer. But when you want something to contour, to add shadows and structure to your face, you'll use something in a matte finish. Okay, I'll just use a little bit along the sides of my nose. You guys like my earrings? Thank you. I'm going to use a blush, and this is one of my favorites. I've been wearing this so much for almost 3 to 4 months now. This is the MAC Mineralized Blush in the shade Love Thing. And I know in the pan it looks like a really scary color. It's this burgundy color with a bit of gold pearl. But if you use the right brush with it, it actually looks really nice on the skin. So I've got the Bobbi Brown Sheer Powder Brush, and it's not too dense. When you're working with a blush that is like, you know, quite bright or quite dark, you don't want a brush that is too dense, because that's going to deposit too much product. So just taking a little bit, and can see, even though it's a really scary color in the pan, it actually looks really nice and fresh on the skin, and it just brightens your face up. Harsha asks, best pink lipstick with warm undertones. I'm going to use a really nice warm pink lipstick in just about a minute. So that's going to answer your question. Best moisturizer for oily skin. I really like the Clinique moisturizers. So they're dramatically different hydrating jelly, which comes in a clear bottle. That's actually really nice for oily skin. You can also use the Moisture Surge. This is not a very heavy moisturizer. This also works for oily skin. How are you? I'm very well, thank you. Got my blush. And now I just need a bit of highlighter to complete the cheeks. What I'm going to use is the lightest, this color right here from the Estee Lauder eyeshadow palette, the same one that I used for my eyes. And I'm just going to grab an eyeshadow brush. If you don't have anything else, you can just use this to highlight. And then you can pull back in with your fingers to make sure it's like nicely blended. A little bit of this on my brow bone as well. And when you do that, it just gives a little bit of a lift to your eyebrow. Just a tiny bit on my nose. Left now is a lip. So I'm going to use the new Luxe Matte lipstick from Bobbi Brown. This shade is called Follow Your Rose. And it's a really nice warm pink color. I think this is something that's going to work for all skin tones. And I have to say that applicator is really nice. It's not too big, so you can do, you know, the corners and the edges in a very precise way. And this actually feels really comfortable to wear, and that's something I love about Bobbi Brown lipsticks, that even the ones that have a matte finish are just very comfortable on the lips. They never feel dry or stretchy. In case some of you missed out, this is the shade is called Follow Your Rose, and this is Bobbi Brown Luxe Matte Lipstick. So that is my finished look. I also want to tell you guys about three really nice nail products from Nykaa, which I've been liking lately. And these are the ones. This is the 7-in-1 nail spa. It's great if you have like really weak nails, because it does like a lot of different things. It makes your nails stronger. So if you have brittle nails, if you have weak nails, try this one, the 7-in-1 nail spa. I also really like the matte top coat. I do like glossy nails, but sometimes it gets like repetitive, so you can use the matte top coat to instantly get a more matte finish for your nails. And then the last product I really like is the double duty 2-in-1 coat. You can use this as a base coat, you can use it as a top coat, and I think that's really important when you're doing your nails, because if you don't use a base and a matte, sorry, a base and a top coat, your nail polish chips a lot easier. Also, you don't get as nice of a finish if you don't use a base coat and a top coat. So this is great because it works as both. You don't need two separate products. So if you're looking for something that's going to work as a top coat and a base coat, try the double duty. And that is it for this live session. I'm just going to take a few questions for those of you who joined in late. Just tell you again of the products. Fida asks, what is that lip shade? So what I'm wearing is it's called Follow Your Rose by Bobbi Brown. It's their liquid lipstick and I love this color. It's such a fresh, bright color, also great for summer. And about dry skin. If you have dry skin, use products which are more oil based rather than water based. So that's going to give you the nourishment you need. Also avoid something that's too matte. Use more of creams and liquids rather than using a lot of powder products. And that is it for this live session. Thank you for tuning in, guys. And to all of those of you in Kanpur who come to see me later today, I'm really excited and I can't wait to see you. Thank you. And do stay tuned to the Nayaka handle, because we'll be doing lots of stories from the event later on. And that's all for this live session. Thank you so much.